Hey everybody, it's Tristan and welcome back to my YouTube channel. So today I am here with another video and I know it has been over a month since I've last posted and I am going to explain why right now. So the reason is really nothing crazy, it's just the fact that this video that I'm posting right now is my 100th video. And for the longest time I've been telling myself that the 100th video for this channel is going to be my coming out story. And so I've been uploading and then I realized, oh crap, my next video is my coming out video. And honestly, for the longest time, I've been putting off making this video just because it is a long story and this video is not just gonna be how I told my family, friends, and everybody and all that, that I was gay. It's going to be like the whole story from when I was young and like what led up to me coming out and all that kind of stuff. So I just wanted to tell the story right. I didn't wanna rush it. I didn't want to make it fast just because I had to. So I've been sitting on it for the past month as soon as I like realized like, holy shit, like I need to make this video next because I had been telling myself that I needed to and I had been putting it off. So I told myself, Tristan, video 100, that is the coming out video. You've been putting off this story long enough and it's one that I want to share. So I gave myself a deadline. I came to that deadline, but I wasn't ready to do it. But now I kind of feel like I am. I have it all in my notes. I have it all bulleted, the things I want to hit. It has been a long time since a lot of these things have happened. So I have it all in my notes ready to go. I will be referencing it just so I don't forget anything. I don't want to like leave anything out of the story. So I have this handy just so I don't. But before we get started, I do just want to thank you guys for being patient with me and all that. I haven't really been active on any social media recently, except for Twitter I'm fairly active on, but like Instagram I haven't posted on since August. On YouTube I haven't posted on since August. And we're now into October, so it's about time that I'm getting back into the groove of all of this. But I do really just want to thank you guys for being patient with me, and I hope you guys enjoy this video. It is a story. It is a long one. I don't know how long this video is going to be, but I'm talking about a lot of things from years ago and events that have happened that have led up to now. And I really don't know how emotional I'm gonna get while filming this. Like, I might be totally fine, I might be a mess, I might be somewhere in between, but I'm gonna be digging deep and remembering a lot of emotions that I was feeling at the times that I have listed and all of that. Like, I'm gonna really be remembering everything that I was feeling, so I don't know how I'm gonna like act during all this. I might be fine, like I said, or I might be a mess or somewhere in between, but I'm gonna be completely honest with you guys about everything and we will see how it goes. But without any further ado, this is my coming out story. So we are gonna start off around the time that I was like 6, 7-ish, like early elementary school years, or just like elementary school in general kind of. So at that time in my life, I knew that I was different. I was not like all the other little boys that were in my class or anything like that. I just wasn't. Like, they all played a lot of sports and really enjoyed it. They played with cars and all that kind of stuff. And I did play with cars and I did play sports, but I really did not enjoy playing sports. It was just kind of like a thing that me and my brother did. And honestly, at that point, I loved playing with dolls and playing dress up and all that kind of stuff. Like, I had my sister and my girl cousins, and I literally would have to convince them to play with dolls and dress up and stuff. Like, they enjoyed it, but I enjoyed it more and more often, which I know probably drove them crazy, but that's just how that was. Like, I loved playing with that kind of stuff, and I used them as an excuse to be able to. I was just like, oh, I'm not really the one that wants to play with it. I'll just be nice and play with my sister and my cousins. But in reality, like, I was the one who really wanted to, and they knew that, but they were all good sports and they played with me, so shout out to them. And along with that, I also picked female characters, like whenever I was playing a video game or something. I did that quite a bit, like just little things that don't necessarily mean anything, but I just specifically remember, like, I would always want the girl toys from McDonald's and I'd say, like, I'm gonna give it to my sister, but I would keep that stuff. I just liked more feminine things. But I also liked playing outside, I liked playing with cars and stuff. Like, I didn't just like those things, but like living in the Midwest in a more conservative area, like, it was kind of not normal for a young boy to be playing with these things. So I definitely used my sister and my cousins as like a cover up so I'd be able to. So that was kind of the home life situation when I was that age in terms of me like realizing that I was a little bit different and that I wasn't like everybody else. But then we get into actual school. Now, this was a time in my life I was so immensely bullied in elementary school. Like, crazy. The kids were honestly so ruthless and awful, like, for no good reason. I minded my own business and I was nice to people, but people were not nice to me. Like, all the other boys in my grade at this time would call me gay all the time, and like, I didn't even know at this age what that meant. I went home one day and I told my mom that kids were calling me gay, and then she asked me like if I knew what that meant, and I just said it was a boy who acts like a girl, which, I mean, kind of is right. And I don't remember if she explained to me what it actually was or not, but the bottom line, at this point, I didn't have any experience exposure to the LGBT or anything. And I was like 8 at this point or something, and I just didn't have any exposure to anything gay, like, at all. I'm the oldest sibling, so I didn't have an older sibling finding out all these things and informing me of it at home. I just had my classmates call me something that I didn't know, like, what it meant. Because at home, it was never really discussed. Like, it wasn't discussed in a good way, it wasn't discussed in a bad way. Like, I just did not know what it meant. So in my head, I just kind of formed the thought of it was a boy who acts like a girl, which I thought at the time, like, oh, maybe I am. Like, I do kind of act more feminine or whatever, and I didn't even know what the word feminine meant at the time either. So me and my mom had that conversation, and it was so long ago, like, I don't really remember specifics of it, but life just kind of went on as usual. But the bullying just kept happening all the time. I literally, at 9 years old, was telling my mom that I didn't want to go to school and I didn't want to be alive. Like, I would rather die than go back to school. Like, honestly, how messed up is it that at 9 years old, I am being so relentlessly bullied that I want to die? It's actually insane. And that was around 4th grade. So my mom started taking me to therapy because she was like, I freaked her out. Like, and I can totally imagine why. Like, I'm talking about not wanting to live and I'm a kid. But eventually I stopped going to therapy. Like, I apparently got better enough to where my mom didn't feel like it was necessary anymore and I was doing good. But honestly, the moral of, like, the whole elementary school experience, like, it was bad. Like, one time my friends, which I didn't have many of at the time at all, they told my mom the names of specific kids who were being shitty to me. She marched, and this was during lunch, like, she came to school, like, for lunch and visited me and all that. She marched out to the playground, and she knew who these kids were because she went to school with their parents, but she got up from the table, marched outside to the playground, and ripped these kids' asses. Like, for real. My friends thought that she was a badass at the time, and I was just kind of mortified because I didn't want any kind of repercussion of that from those kids. But from what I remember, bullying wasn't as bad, or just, like, I don't really remember it being. I'm sure kids were still shitty every once in a while, but it wasn't as relentless and awful as it once was. And I do actually wanna say one other thing that happened during elementary school that is extremely sad and that my mom told me. And then, like, when she told me it, I kind of remember saying it, but I don't remember it as vividly as I'm sure that she does. But it was in the midst of bullying being really bad, and I felt like I didn't really have any friends. And she told me, Tristan, why don't you make friends with the most unpopular kid in your class and, like, be nice to them and be their friend. Like, help someone or be around someone that's going through the same things that you are. And I came up with a name of that person, but they were actually about to leave our school and go to a different one. And I told her that, and then she asked me, okay, well, who's the second least popular? And I told her it was me. And that broke her heart, like, immensely. And at that time, I really do believe that I thought that I was the at least second most unpopular kid in my class. And now sitting here looking back on that situation, I kind of still believe it. Like, there were some people who were unpopular, but they had a core group of friends who they hung out with and that liked them and whatever else. I had a couple friends, but, like, I didn't really hang out with them outside of school or anything. I had friends, but they weren't, like, really good friends. I had one good friend, and then I was kind of friends by default with theirs. Not all of them, but some of them. So things around that time were rough, but they did end up getting better. Like, I was diagnosed with dyslexia when I was in elementary school, so I just kind of thought, like, anything that was different about me was kind of having to do with that as well. But it was a completely different thing that I didn't really have any knowledge of, which is being gay. Like, I don't know, it's just so much to deal with when you're a kid, and, like, you don't know what to do because you don't even know what's going on. So that was pretty much the elementary school years. School was rough, but then it was better, and my home life was good. My parents got divorced, but I still had good relationships with both of them, like, individually. So for me, really, I don't remember that having any kind of massive toll on me. And now we're moving on to middle school, and middle school compared to elementary school was so much better. Like, there are still some shitty people every once in a while, but in middle school, at least in my town, this is how it's laid out. There are 4 elementary schools, but then when those kids get to 6th grade, they go to the middle school where there's 6th, 7th, and 8th grade. And the 4 classes, say, like, okay, I was in 5th grade going into 6th grade. The 5th grade classes from all 4 of those schools, technically 5 if you count the Catholic school that I went to when I was younger, like in kindergarten or whatever. But anyways, the same class from those schools combine into 1 class. So that is a huge opportunity to make new friends, because there's, like, all these kids from these 3 other schools or 4 that you have never met before, more than likely, or who you didn't know. So when 6th grade started, I started making a lot more friends. So things instantly got better because I had a new group of people that I was vibing with, and things just were looking much more up than they were at my elementary school because I met new people and I just got along with them better and I related to them more and I just really, really enjoyed their company. So middle school was instantly better, but I was still closeted as hell. I remember I was trying to get this girl who I liked to date me, and this was like in eighth grade. I'm kind of skipping ahead a little bit, but also in middle school, I started developing some crushes, and I was starting to find guys somewhat attractive, and I didn't know what this meant, so like I was heavily suppressing my thoughts and feelings, like hardcore. Like I was still trying to get a girlfriend in middle school, like having crushes, but honestly, like it wasn't like oh, I want to date you crush. It was you're nice to me crush, and you are pretty or whatever, and I feel like I need a girlfriend to like fit in or whatever, so I tried to date that person. Like I didn't actually like this person, but I kind of thought I did because they were nice to me and they were a pretty girl in seventh grade or whatever. I don't know. I hope you understand what I'm saying by that, but along with just trying to get a girlfriend, I was also kind of starting to like guys. Like I'd be in gym class and I'd be looking at a guy and be like, okay, I don't know what's like going on here, like in my head, but like you, I'm kind of developing some feels of some sort towards you. It was a whole situation that I didn't know how to deal with, so I suppressed that hardcore, and I kind of started to realize what gay actually meant at this time, because more people around, more people would inform me, and I was just telling myself like, you're not gay, you're not into guys. Like everything started to like make a little bit more sense, but I just suppressed it hardcore, which I think most people who were gay at some point in their lives did, because that's just like the natural response, I guess. Like if you're feeling like I shouldn't be this way, or I'm thinking something that I shouldn't be thinking, you just suppress it and you try to ignore it as much as you can. So middle school was a lot better. I started making new friends, but I was also just very conflicted in like the relationship and dating scene, because everyone around me, they were like dating whenever at 13, and I was heavily single and I didn't even really fully know who I was attracted to. Like in the back of my mind, I kind of knew who I was attracted to, but no one around me was like openly like that at that point, and I wasn't even either. So I was just trying to date girls who I wasn't really friends with but who were nice to me. So it was just a very confusing time in my life. So everything that I've told you thus far has kind of been like a prerequisite. It's just been like my feelings and like my emotions and my mindset and everything building up to what I'm about to talk about. So now we are getting into high school. Freshman year was good, everything's going swimmingly. Honestly, pretty much throughout high school, I didn't really have any bad bullying at all. Of course, there's always gonna be people who are dicks to you, but no one was like bullying me at all. I had kind of come into my own a little bit more. I had a core group of friends who I really liked and who I'm still in touch with to this day. I love them to death. Like I have so many good memories with them that I will literally cherish forever. And those relationships actually started in like late middle school and like carried into high school. So around that time, like late middle school, early freshman year, so like 13, 14 years old, going into when I was 15, everything's going good. I'm single. I'm just telling myself, literally I wrote this in a freshman letter to myself. I actually might read this to you guys one of these days. But in this letter, I remember I wrote something like, you don't have a girlfriend right now, but that's all right. Like you'll meet the right girl eventually. But like I, so in freshman year, I was still like denying it, heavily denying it. And I actually denied it up until, I believe the exact date was June 28th, 2014. That is the day that I met my first massive guy crush. So at this time I was 16 and he was 15, and he was a brother of one of my friends. And this friend was like a couple years older than me. And for the sake of this video, I am going to call this person Daniel. I'm not going to give out their real name or anything. But I met Daniel at the fair in my town that summer after my sophomore year. So at this point, I had been suppressing my feelings like hardcore, like ridiculously. And I was still finding guys attractive, and it was like starting to bubble up in me a little bit more, but I still like hardcore denied it. But after I actually started talking to this person more and was interacting with them more, I developed a massive crush. Like I was eventually like in love with this boy. And that day was the start of one of the best and most painful emotionally 5 months of my life. No joke. So newsflash guys, Daniel here that I'm talking about is straight. So that's already a recipe for disaster. In my mind, I'm like, I don't care. Like I cannot deny this in me anymore. I am gay. I am into this guy so much. Like I want to be with him. Like I want to date him. I am heavily into this person. But it was just a bad situation mentally for me. Like me, him, and two of my best friends, us four, we hung out all the time during that summer, like a lot. And during those 5 months that we hung out, so it was so about like the end of June through November-ish, about like so about those 5 months, during that time it became kind of like a twilight love triangle kind of situation. So as I've said, I was in love with this guy, like hardcore, like my feelings for him were insane. But he developed feelings for one of those best friends that we were hanging out with, and for the sake of all of this, I'll call her Marsha. So this guy Daniel started started developing feelings for Marcia. And so basically, here's how this love triangle went. Let's say I'm Jacob. So Jacob is in love with Bella, aka Daniel. Daniel, Bella, is in love with Edward, who is Marcia. So Jacob is in love with Bella, Bella's in love with Edward. So in this case, I am in love with Daniel, Daniel is in love with Marcia. But in this situation, Marcia did not reciprocate feelings for Bella. So in this situation, Jacob and Edward are best friends and Edward doesn't want to date Bella. I hope that makes sense. I think it does. But I didn't make it known publicly, like talk about out loud to these best friends that I had these feelings for Daniel. I'm sure honestly they knew, like a lot of my friends, they would ask me about it throughout the years, like if I was gay or whatever, but I hardcore denied it to myself, denied it to all of these people. But I'm sure at this point they had caught on to like that I like this person. But it got to a point where I was like constantly upset because I knew this person, like I was subtly flirting and all these things, maybe not so subtly, who knows, but I was flirting with this person and I wasn't getting anything back. So I was really into them and I wanted to, like, in my heart, give them everything, be that person for them, but they didn't reciprocate those feelings because they couldn't, because they're straight. And I just would not accept that. And it got ridiculous. Like, honestly, like I say that now, but at the time, like I was extremely heartbroken. And my best friend, Marcia, like she's still like my best friend now. She straight up almost just dropped me. She could not handle this constant emotional roller coaster that would happen every time we all hung out, or if it was just us hanging out, like I'd constantly wanna hang out with him and all this stuff. It was just not fair to our friend group or whatever that I was this much of a mess over something that I couldn't change. And so I remember I was at my dad's house sobbing in my bed and I was texting Marcia. I didn't tell her I was gay, but I basically did. I was like, I'm in love and all of this kind of stuff. And even after I did that, I was still like constantly like an emotional wreck. So at this point, she eventually for sure knew and she was trying to help me handle it. But what she was basically saying was just like, you need to move on from it. Like, it's not gonna happen. Like, it cannot happen. And she was right 100%, but I couldn't accept that. It was such an emotionally draining 5 months for me, I know, but I'm sure for her and my other friend as well, and probably even Daniel, because I know he caught on and all this stuff and he knew eventually as well. And these are pretty much like the first people who found out. But I do remember like a part of this story that happened during these 5 months. I did tell one person, I think, before I told Marcia, and we'll call her Shelby. So this girl also liked Daniel. And I was friends with this girl, and in my mind I'm thinking, okay, if either of us two are gonna get him, it's gonna be me. Like, he's not gonna go for you, whatever. And we were friends, but we weren't like really close friends. So she was kind of like a practice run in terms of telling people that I was gay. So I told her, just because it was easier than telling like family or my close friends or anything like that. And this was at a football game at our high school that I told her. We were working the concession stand together. And so then after that, everything was peachy keen, and she would come out to my house and hang out with us sometimes as well. Well, this bitch, I'm over it now, honestly, but like just thinking about it, it's just so irresponsible. And so like, you shouldn't have done this kind of thing. Like, I'm really not mad about it now, it's whatever. But she went and told someone that was in my grade, and this girl was like, I think a year younger than me, but she went and told this person who she was friends with that I was gay. And I'm just like, I'm not friends with this person, and you're just all of a sudden like telling my business to people. So it was very unsettling for me, and it really rubbed me the wrong way. And I hadn't had like the best experience with this specific individual in the past. Like, at that time we were fine or whatever, but it was just a situation that I was kind of upset about, and also something that happened during these 5 months. And I think at the time I was pissed at Marcia for this, but looking back I really don't care. But she actually made out with Daniel. Does she reciprocate feelings for him? No, but she had just gotten out of a relationship and she was like rebounding or whatever. So Daniel was getting like a little taste of love there and I was getting nothing. So I was like kind of like dying inside, kind of. I knew they weren't gonna date really or whatever, but it was just like, so basically my best friend made out with the guy I was in love with, but it's fine. It was just such an emotional and insane 5 months, honestly. Me and Daniel are good. We talk and like we've hung out. Those feelings are really no longer there. Like, after all of that, like I would not want to emotionally be attached to that person in that way again. Like, I just know. So those feelings are gone, thank goodness. He's straight still, so none of that's changed. And me and Marcia and the other best friend are still best friends that were in that friends group. I don't really know that Daniel and all of them still really talk that much, but bottom line, everyone that was in that situation, we're good. And Daniel's sister, who I was friends with, we're also still good. But why that story of that specific guy is so important is because the crush I had on that guy and the feelings I had for him were what made me realize that I was gay. Like, I don't think I would have laid in bed sobbing over a guy that I love but who doesn't love me back in that way, who I just can't have if I wasn't gay. You know? And why I say it was like the best and worst 5 months of my life, is because I was like in love with this person, and looking back, I don't know if I was actually in love. I might have been, I don't know. Like, if I'm in love, I wanna consider that like it's a mutual, like we're in love thing. But I very, very much liked this person, like a lot, if not was in love with them. But what I was saying was basically it's like the best and worst 5 months of my life, because it was the best because I got to hang out with this person a lot, and that summer was great in that aspect, and those couple months after summer as well. But they were also the worst because I was going through so much emotional stuff, like just so much sadness, and it was just, it was a lot. Glad I snapped out of it, glad I got to keep my friends, and that it just didn't like implode my life in a way. So we're good now in that situation, but that is an important part of this whole story. So now at this point in the story, I pretty much had my first love who didn't love me back, but at this point I'm like over it and things are better now. So now I think at this point in the story, it's like November, December-ish of 2014. So this is when I started telling my friends at school that I was gay. So not Marsha and them, because they already knew, but like that friends group that I was talking about earlier from 8th grade, and a bunch of other friends that I've made up to this point. So what I did was I went to all of my best friends, like the ones that I was really close with, and then some other ones that I was like friends with but not really close with, but I just started pulling them aside at school one day and telling them like, hey, just wanted to let you know that I'm gay. And most of them were like, yeah, we know, but we're still really happy for you. So I got a really good response from like all of my friends. They were very supportive, and nothing changed after that, and we were peachy keen. I just kind of let the rumor mill do its thing. Like, I came out to those friends, but I didn't tell them that they couldn't tell anybody else. Like, it wasn't a secret at this point. Like, I just let those friends tell other people, and then those people will tell other people, and just like a cycle. So eventually everyone like officially knew. And at this point, everyone like could pretty much guess, like I was pretty flamboyant, so it wasn't like a huge shock or anything, but it still felt good to have people know. Like, it was such a weight lifted off my shoulders. So at this point, we are well into my junior year and my friends know I'm gay. Like, I'm feeling more confident, like things are going pretty well. And then I kind of develop my second crush. Now, I've had crushes before this last big one that made me realize I was gay, but that big one was like, that was the crush. But then I started developing a little bit of other crushes afterwards. Like, I'm trying to move on, like focus on other guys and like find someone else to date or just spend time with and enjoy their company. So I find a guy, and for the sake of this story, we're gonna call him Alex. Now, Alex is in this situation, he's in my grade, so he's my age, and Alex is a jock. He's on the football team. So of course my little gay self is attracted to like a really hot guy on the football team. Like, that's really not a surprising thing, but you can imagine probably not gonna end well. And also, newsflash, Alex is straight. So I'm putting myself back into another shitty situation that is not gonna end well, but I'm just going for it and I'm gonna see what happens. So it kind of became known that I had feelings for Alex, because I wasn't really trying to hide it at this point, but I had told one of my friends that I liked him. But this friend just so happened to have dated Alex before. So I think she kind of informed him or whatever, but I don't really blame her for him knowing. I told a lot of people, and I'm sure people heard and they spread that around to other people that I liked him or whatever. But bottom line, I told her that, and I don't really remember her reaction much, but I think it was someone along the lines of, I don't really know that that's a really good idea, but I mean, go for it, I guess. Like, shoot your shot, basically. Bottom line, at this point, Alex finds out that I like him, and he just kind of makes a joke out of the situation in an asshole-y kind of way. Like, he's talking to his cousins about it and his friends or whatever, and they're just being dicks about it. Like, I haven't like flirted with him publicly or anything, or trying to make like a spectacle. Like, I just have feelings for this person, and like, by have feelings, like, I found him attractive. Honestly, his personality at the time at least was like questionable and not something I should have really been trying to date. So anyways, I overhear Alex being an asshole about the whole situation and talking about me. And also the girl that he dated, who's my friend, also told me about it. So I just had a lot of confirmation that he was being a dick. So at this point I was pissed. So I go to all my friends and I start talking shit on him. Like, not about him, but just about the whole situation, about how like he's being an asshole about it. And just like, I am really, really pissed about it, which I think is totally understandable. Like, if you're gonna be a dick and you can dish it, then you should be able to take it because you're doing it. So like, I was just mad, and it was just kind of like a shit talking to each other's friends kind of deal. So at this point I'm pissed. Like, he's talking shit about me, so I'm just like, okay, well, I'm gonna talk shit about you to my friends because I'm pissed and I need to vent to somebody. So through one way or another, I'm pretty sure people just overheard me talking or whatever, but he finds out that I'm talking shit on him. So he gets this idea, and I don't really blame him for this like misinformation. I feel like he just kind of heard wrong, or someone gave him the wrong information, but he's told that I'm talking shit on him and his family, like personally attacking him and his cousin and whoever else, which is not true at all. So at this point, there's a great deal of miscommunication, because we haven't like personally one-on-one talked about any of this. Not me liking him and not what either of us are saying about each other. So that's just like a recipe for a whole lot of nothing good. So a friend of mine who's a mutual friend of both Alex and I, she tells me like, hey, I heard that he's gonna like confront you after school and like basically like physically hurt you. And so I find out about that like 20 minutes before the bell rings or something for the end of the day. And I am petrified. Like this guy is kind of like, he's bigger than me. So I'm like just sitting here like panicking. Like, okay, I just need to get to my locker. Then I need to get out the door into my car and go. Like not stick around for anything to like happen or whatever. But here's where things get interesting. So I get to my locker and I'm like talking to some friends, getting my stuff out of my locker ready to go. I'm still like kind of on edge, but I haven't seen this guy yet. So I'm kind of thinking like, okay, we're fine. I'm surrounded by a lot of people. There are some teachers over like around the corner. So like we should be good. But then Alex shows up and he looks at me and he's like, so I hear you're talking shit on me and my family. Like basically something along those lines. I'm like, no, that's not what I said. Like if you would like to have an actual conversation about this, like I'd like to talk about it and clear all this up. I was trying to be reasonable and de-escalate the situation. But instead he goes and he pushes me into the lockers behind me. And not only into like the lockers, but also into somebody else that then falls into somebody else, which then falls into somebody else. So I get slammed partially into a person, but mostly into a metal locker. And then they like fall into people because like a domino effect. And me in that moment, I was petrified. Like I was just standing there like in shock, did not know what to do. So he left and he basically said like, next time if this keeps happening, it's gonna be worse. So he threatened me. Cool. Basically after that, like everyone hated him for good reason. I mean, he literally just pushed me into a locker because of a misunderstanding that he did not want to like talk about and clear up. So after all of that, me and my brother got my car and we drove home and he didn't see any of that, but like he eventually found out because we went to the same school. And to my knowledge, it was a pretty talked about thing at the time. And also like when I'm leaving, like some teachers come around. And at this time, I think it was the principal. She like comes around the corner and she's trying to figure out like what's going on, like what just happened. And by this time, Alex has already left. And so like all of my friends and other people around me are like explaining what happened. And so I just don't know what to do. And since she didn't like see anything, like I don't really know like what the whole situation was at this point. Like I was pretty flustered and I just wanted to get out of there. So she just kind of like leaves it be because he's gone and she didn't really like see what happened. So it was like the end of the day. So like, we're just gonna let it go for now at least. So I get home and then my mom gets a phone call. And this phone call is from one of her best friends at the time. And that friend of hers, her daughter is actually like my best friend from elementary school. So we've known each other for a long time. And so is my mom and this person she was friends with. But anyways, that friend of mine had seen me get pushed. So when I got home, she was texting me like asking like, hey, are you okay? Is everything all right? Like, are you good? Like I saw all that and that was like a whole freaking mess. Like I need to know that you're okay after all that. And I just tell her like, yeah, I'm fine. Don't worry about it, whatever. Like I did not want to make a big deal out of the situation. Like I didn't want to escalate it anymore. But being the good and concerned friend that she is, she told her mom and her mom called my mom and told her. And she told her that I got pushed into a locker, but really not much else than that because she didn't know what else there was to talk about in terms of the situation. So at this point, I'm at home sitting in my room, actually in this exact room that I'm sitting in now. And she comes in and she asks me about me getting pushed into a locker. She tells me who told her and I'm just sitting here like internally panicking because I have not told my mom or any other family at this point that I'm gay. And me being gay is a massive part of why I get pushed into a locker because I like a guy and there were miscommunications with that. And now I've been pushed into a locker and now I have to explain it. So because of this whole situation that just happened, I'm kind of being forced to come out to my mom. Like I'm not gonna lie to her and I have to tell her about why I got pushed into a locker because now she knows about the situation. So I sit down and I cannot get the words out of my mouth. And I'm like making her guess about what it is. And then she eventually guesses like, are you gay? And I say, yeah, or just nod my head or something. I don't remember what I did. Totally accepting, totally like still loving. She said it did not like change the way she thought of me at all. And I knew that she had lesbian friends and all that. So I knew that she was not homophobic or anything like that, but it was still just in my mind, it had been hard to do. So I just hadn't done it yet. It was easier to tell friends than it was my family because I just didn't know for sure how they were gonna react. Like I didn't think at least my mom was gonna have a bad reaction, but I just hadn't been able to bring myself to do it at that time. But she had told me that she had known that I was gay since I was 3, or at least had a very strong suspicion of it. So like this whole time, like throughout my life, like everything that's going on, she's just pretty much known even before I had even brought it up in elementary school. So I have now told my mom because I kind of had to, because I had to explain like I like this guy, there was a misunderstanding, got pushed into a locker and all of that. So I have now at this point told her and my friends. But I tell you guys, after I did, I felt like the most relief I had felt in a long time. Like, it felt like there was a massive weight lifted off my shoulders. Like, I was instantly just like, I felt like I could breathe better. It was amazing. But I was just happy that that was out of the way. And in terms of that situation, like, I probably could have pressed charges or something or got the guy expelled, but he had never done anything to me before. And I don't know how he was really to other people, but I, in my mind, did not want him to get in that much trouble. I didn't want that decision, as shitty and awful as it was, to like mess up his life in some way. Like, I didn't want to be responsible for someone else's life getting screwed up. So I didn't want to like press charges or get him expelled or get like anybody involved. Like, I just told administration, like, it's fine. I don't want to do this. I told my mom that too. Like, I just want to leave it alone. I want to let it die. I want to move on from it. Like, this doesn't need to be a thing, and I don't want someone else's life to get messed up because of it. Even if they might deserve it, I don't want that to happen. And despite all that happening, me and Alex are good now. It's good to forgive and not live in the past and dwell on stuff like that. So we're Gucci, and we move on from it. And that's the end of that drama, but that story is important, and that's because of all this happening and me having that crush or whatever, it kind of forced me to come out. Like, it gave me a really strong nudge to where I had to do it. And I'm honestly, looking back at it now, I'm so, so grateful that it did happen, because like, was it kind of mortifying at the time? Absolutely, but it pushed me in a direction that I needed to go. And it made something happen that needed to happen, because if it hadn't, I don't know when I would have told my mom or anybody else in my family that I was gay. Like, it could have been like another freaking year, or she could have found out a different way. And it was just, I'm glad it didn't take any longer, and I'm glad everything happened the way it did. Like, everything happens for a reason, and I'm just glad that I was able to tell her and that things were fine. And the day that all of that happened, that I told my mom and everything, was December 11th, 2014. I remember that so vividly, like, I have not forgotten. But after I told her all that, I told her, like, you cannot tell anybody else. Like, please do not tell dad, do not tell your parents, because my mom's parents are very religious people, and really so is my whole mom's side of the family. And then my dad's side of the family is more kind of like redneck and crazy and fun, but like, just not people who I really envisioned being super accepting of the LGBTQ community. I mean, I didn't know it for sure, and I hadn't like heard them say like any nasty homophobic things ever, but I just didn't know, and I was just like scared in my mind, like overthinking things, and I was just worried that they wouldn't be accepting of me and that I would lose family. So I told my mom, like, please don't tell your parents or anybody else, and she said okay, and she didn't for a little bit. But she did end up telling her parents, my grandma and grandpa, just because she kind of knew their views on it, and they aren't really like super crazy about the idea of it or whatever. Like, they are totally loving towards me now, do not treat me any kind of negative way at all. But she ended up telling them just because she didn't want them to figure out through someone else or through some other kind of way. And that's mostly because she wanted to and did sit them down, and she was like, listen, this is the situation, this is how it is, and if you have a problem with it, then you can be completely removed from it. Like, she like wasn't gonna let them be any type of negative way towards me because I was gay. So I wasn't there for the conversation, but it basically went like, you can have these beliefs, but you're not gonna treat my kid in a shitty way because of them. So shout out to my mom for having my back always. Like, since I was born, she has always been there for me. She is one of the, if not the best part of me and like my life and everything. I love her to death, like, truly so much. And she has never not been there for me. So she like helped me immensely through this and like made sure I was loved and taken care of. So now at this point, her and her parents, my grandparents and all my friends at school, they know. But my siblings don't know, my dad doesn't know, and no other members of my family on either side know. So I came up with the game plan, and I was gonna have my mom executed, because I was really still at this point too mortified to. Like, I was too scared and I couldn't do it. So in June and into July of 2015, I was in Europe, and it was for like this music ambassadors thing. Like, I went around with some people from my school who were in like choir and band and all that, and some other people who were also in choir and band but in other surrounding schools in Kansas. And we went to Europe and we performed at different churches and different venues, and it was just such a really, really fun, like, what, 16 days I think it was? A little bit more than 2 weeks. And it was a really fun time. But while I was there, like within the first few days of me being there, I was gonna have my mom tell my dad and my siblings and her side of the family, and then have my dad tell his side of the family, or her, I don't know who did what. I think it was him. But bottom line, I was gonna have her tell everyone else that I was gay, because I could not fathom in my mind sitting each individual person down and telling them that I was gay. It was just not something that I could do at the time, at least. Like, I could not do it. So she informed me when I was in Europe that she was gonna start doing it, and I was like petrified. Like, I was 1500 miles away and I like made sure of that, and I was still scared. Like, I just did not want to be around for that, just in case. But like, in my mind, I was ready to cut off like every member of my family if I had to, like my aunts and uncles and grandparents or whoever. Like, I love them to death and still do, but at that time I was like, this is me, and if you can't love me and accept me as I am, then I don't need you in my life. And that's a fact. So I had mentally prepared myself to do that, but luckily I did not have to. But she told my siblings and they were just like, we know. Which is hilarious. Like, I'm sure you did know. Like, it was not subtle or anything. Like, it's just funny looking back at it because it was kind of obvious. And she told my dad and he was like, okay, that doesn't change anything. So he had a really good response to it, thank God. He was one person that was the most nervous knowing about, just because I did not know in any way how he was gonna handle it. But luckily it went over totally fine. But then my mom told the rest of her family, and I'm pretty sure my dad told all of his family. And so everyone knew and everything was peachy. I actually am so lucky. I had such a good response from my whole family, and some people just are not as lucky as I am. I consider myself so extremely lucky that I got the response that I did. But the day that my mom had been telling people, I started getting texts. Like, I got a call from my dad. He asked me how I was doing. Like, he knew at this point, and he didn't ask me about like me being gay or coming out or any of that. He was just like checking in on me, made sure I was having a good trip. And I was like really nervous like during that call, but we ended it, had a normal conversation, and everything was fine. And I got a text from one of my aunts saying that she was proud of me, which meant a lot to me. Like, it was just an overall really good experience and a really good day, even though like I wasn't the one who actually did it. Like, the results were so much better than I was expecting, and I am so grateful for that. Like, in the back of my mind, I was thinking like, okay, the super religious people are going to crucify me, and the more redneck people are going to drag me behind a truck through the streets of town. Like, I was like thinking the absolute worst was going to happen without really giving them the benefit of the doubt, just because I was so scared. But everything ended up going well, and at that point everyone knew that I was gay. And yeah, guys, I think that's the end of my coming out story. Pretty much all my friends and family found out like separately over the course of like 6 months. So it did take a while for everybody to find out, but like it happened how it needed to. And I'm just so incredibly grateful that I have the support system and the love from everybody that I do. I know how lucky I am because I've watched other coming out videos on YouTube, and I see people who have no love and no acceptance from any member of their family or any of their friends or anything like that. And that is terrible. And I am just so incredibly lucky and blessed and grateful that I have the kind of love and support that I do. And it's really not something that I take for granted. Like, I consider myself extremely lucky. But yeah, guys, that is the end of the story and the end of this video. Thank you guys so much for sitting down and taking the time to listen to my coming out story. It really does mean a lot to me. It's not the most like happy story in the world, but it is mine, and it is important to me and to the person that I've become. But yeah, guys, just thank you again so much for listening, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye, guys.